Welcome to a second video on using the zero feature of the TI84 graphing calculator to find the real rational zeros or roots of a polynomial function. We should already know by now that the possible rational zeros of this function would be the factors of the constant term, in this case 15, over the factors of the leading coefficient, which is 6. So here are the factors of 15. Notice that we have to consider both the positive and negative factors, and here are the factors of 6. From here, we'd make a list of possible rational zeros by looking at all the possible ratios of these factors. So for example, if we started with this factor of 1, we'd have plus or minus 1 over 1, which is just plus or minus 1, plus or minus 1 over 2 or 1 half, given here, plus or minus 1 over 3, which is plus or minus 1 third, and so on, until we came up with this entire list of possible rational zeros. So in this case, instead of using trial and error to find which of these rational numbers are zeros of the function, we can actually use the graph of the function and the zero feature of the calculator to find these zeros for us. Remember, we're looking for the values of x that make the function equal to 0, or the x values where y is equal to 0. Graphically, that means the x-intercepts of this function would be the real zeros of the function. So let's graph this function on our TI84. From the home screen, we'll press y equals, clear out any old functions we have, and type in the new function. We have 6x cubed. Here's the exponent key on the right. So there's 6x cubed minus 11. For the squared, we can just push this x squared key here. Minus 26x, and then plus 15. Now, to make sure we have the standard window from negative 10 to positive 10 along the x and y axis, let's go ahead and press zoom 6. Notice how this window isn't great. It does show 3x intercepts, which means this function does have 3 real zeros. And now we'll use the zero feature to see if they're also rational. So to do this, we're going to press second trace. Here's the second key in blue. Here's the trace key. And we're going to use the 0 option, which is option 2. We can only find one x-intercept at a time, and each x-intercept we have to identify the left bound and right bound. So if we want to find this x-intercept here to the left, it means we want to place the cursor below this x-intercept. So we're going to press the left arrow until we're below that x-intercept on the left. So this is to the left. I know it's below, but it's also to the left because this function is increasing on this interval. So we press enter. The right bound, we need to go above it, so we press right. It's way up here, and it is above it, so we'll press enter. And then we'll press enter again when it says guess. Notice the x-intercept occurs when x equals negative 1.666667. It's rounding here. This is a repeating decimal, which means this is a rational number. This is the same as negative 1 2/3, or negative 5/3. And just in case you don't recognize this, we could go back to the home screen, pressing second quit, and then enter negative 1.6 with a bunch of sixes. And then we'll ask the calculator to convert this to a fraction, so we'll press math, enter, enter. And notice how it gives us negative 5/3, which is one of the rational zeros. Let's go ahead and write that down. Let's go back and see if we can find the two remaining zeros. So we'll press graph. Now before we find this next x-intercept or zero, let's go ahead and change the window a little bit. We don't need to have the x-axis go from negative 10 to positive 10 since we have the three x-intercepts in here. So let's press the window key. Let's change the x-min to negative 3 and the x-max to positive 3 and see if that makes our graph look better. Looks like we should probably go to positive 4 on the right, so let's go back and change the x max to 4. And now we can see the x-intercepts a little more clearly. So again, we're going to press second trace, option 2. Let's try to find this x-intercept here. So the left of this x-intercept, in this case, would be above because it's decreasing. So I am to the left, so I'll press enter. To the right, we'll press the right arrow so that we're below the x-intercept, press enter, and then for guess, we press enter again. Notice this zero was a lot easier to determine, x equals 0.5 or x equals 1/2. Let's go ahead and write that down. And then for the last zero, and then for this last x-intercept, looks like it will be at x equals 3. Let's go ahead and just check it. Press second, trace, option 2. We're going to scroll to the right so that we're just below the x-intercept. Below it in this case is to the left. If you're ever not sure where the cursor is, it tells you right here. It's at x equals approximately 2.28 right now, so it's getting close. And there it is. So we'll press enter. To the right in this case is above. Press the right arrow, enter, and then enter again. So our last zero or x-intercept is x equals 3. So by using the graph, we're able to find the real rational zeros rather than use this long list of possible rational zeros and find them using trial and error. Now before we go, there's one more connection I'd like to make. Having these zeros of the function does help us factor the polynomial function if needed. Notice our polynomial does not contain any fractions, so while if x equals negative 5/3 is a zero, then x plus 5/3 would be a factor. We don't want fractions in our factors. What we can do here is take this equation here, multiply both sides by 3, that would give us 3x equals negative 5, add 5 to both sides. Notice how we have 3x plus 5 equals 0, so 3x plus 5 would be a factor of our function. So our function, if we want to factor it, would have to have a factor of 3x plus 5. For this equation here, where x equals 1/2, we could multiply both sides by 2. That would give us 2x equals 1. Subtract 1 on both sides, and that would give us 2x minus 1 is equal to 0, which again gives us another factor of our polynomial function. One factor would have to be 2x minus 1. And then for the third 0, it's going to be a lot easier. If x equals positive 3 is a 0, then x minus 3 would have to be a factor of our function. I think it's important to recognize the connection between our rational zeros and our factors. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.